It's time for one Democrat lawmaker to help lead us out of the crime surge. I'm not going to hold my breath. Welcome to the Jason Rantz Show, presented by None Better Tax Resolution. The Puget Sound is under criminal siege. Nearly every single day we wake up to news of another homicide or carjacking, an armed robbery or a drug bust. The Puget Sound region is experiencing untenable levels of crime, and no one in charge seems willing to acknowledge the problem, let alone introduce a plan. Seattle's Soto neighborhood saw a ton of violence recently. Police responded to gunshots to find a man dead at an intersection. There are no suspects. There was an armed robbery turned into a gunfight between motorcyclists. It happened in broad daylight. And it happened the day before that fatal shooting. Out in the Beacon Hill neighborhood, more violence. A fatal stabbing after what sounds to be a domestic violence call. The victim was only 21 years old. And then out in Pierce County, we get the same exact stories. A 15-year-old boy was shot multiple times in the parking lot of an apartment complex. Neither the kid nor his parents are cooperating with police. A woman and a teenage girl, they were shot in broad daylight in central Tacoma. Both thankfully are expected to survive. But then there's a story of three teens and an adult, all arrested for an alleged drive-by shooting. Police say they even shot multiple shots at an officer. Luckily, that officer escaped without any injury. I can list these crimes for days, and it begs the question, where is Democrat leadership? Where is Mayor Bruce Harrell or Victoria Woodards? Where's the King or Pierce County Council members? Where are the Democrat representatives and state senators who supposedly care about these communities? Why is no one stepping up to simply say, hey, we've got a crime crisis, and then explain the plan to get ahead of it? On the screen right now, you're watching a man randomly stab a 51-year-old on a Sound Transit train. Luckily, transit riders came to his rescue and helped prevent a murder. These aren't isolated crimes. They're not anomalies. They're happening too often. And no one steps up to say anything for one simple reason. They don't want to be held accountable for the crisis that they helped to create. You see, Democrats passed laws and implemented policies that created these culture of lawlessness episodes that all of us are experiencing. It started with police defunding. Then prosecutors stopped prosecuting. Judges stop jailing, all to the benefit of restorative justice programs that don't actually work, but they keep getting millions of dollars in funding. At the state level, Democrats effectively legalized drugs. They stopped cops from contacting juvenile suspects and possible witnesses without a lawyer present. And they banned them from vehicular pursuits in almost all cases. Turns out that was the perfect recipe for a crime crisis. And yes, this is the fault of Democrats. Republicans control neither the city councils here nor the state legislature. This is not their doing. Democrats did this. Democrats have to acknowledge the crisis that they created, and they have to address it by walking back their policies and laws. Because if they don't, we're going to continue to see more bloodshed, stolen cars, busted out storefronts, and the never-ending surge of fatal drug overdoses. But which local leader is brave enough to admit fault? Which one can put their ideology and ego aside to be held accountable and play hero with a viable plan? Unfortunately, the truth is, not a single Democrat lawmaker comes to mind. Jason Rantz here with Greg Nunn, your local tax expert and advocate. Greg, thank you so much for coming on.
Hey, Jason. Great to be with you again and talk about these tax issues.
Okay, so why should anyone in trouble with the IRS contact you immediately?
The sooner the better, because it's so much easier to deal with an IRS situation at the beginning than when you're getting toward the end and they're getting very aggressive. And at the same time, it takes that pressure off of you sooner and gives you that peace of mind that, hey, no more fear of going to the mailbox because I'm here helping you.
So by connecting with you, can you assure people that they won't have the IRS on their doorstep or calling them nonstop?
When you have representation, you definitely do not want to talk to the IRS ever. And you don't have to. you are protected by statute, by law, that when you have representation, they have to deal with your representative. And I am acting in your best interest when I'm dealing with the IRS. And I tell you, you don't want to talk to them, it'll just stress you out.
Craig, thank you so much. That was really, really helpful.
Hey, it's my pleasure, and I just really hope that what I've said helps some people that are in tax difficulty.
If you're having trouble with the IRS, then call Greg Nunn. Greg might be able to negotiate a settlement for up to 85% off the original amount owed, including penalties and interest. Call Greg Nunn today. Did you like this video? We have a whole lot more over at ktth.com.